The take of the day is why the media is happy now that the Clippers aren't in the playoffs or in the NBA Finals. So why the media is happy that the Clippers didn't advance in the playoffs? The media is happy because they have nothing to worry about. They have no threat. And, you know, most of the media people that you hear on TV or you know, listen to on a podcast or whatever you might be listening to them on, they're all for the Lakers, or at least most of them are. And anytime the Lakers have a lead, or anytime the Lakers look like a potential, you know, powerhouse team or a team that can, you know, possibly, you know, get to a finals, or anytime they look like a superior team, they're always going to choose the Lakers over the Clippers. That's just the way it is. And, you know, that's just the way it's always been. And even when the Warriors, you know, had their run, you got to give them credit too. You know, a lot of people thought, you know, California was, you know, Warrior Town, which I never thought that. I mean, honestly, you know, Lakers got 17 or 18 championships, so it's not even close if you ask me. But the media is definitely happy that the Clippers aren't in the playoffs still, because when you look at it, they're the only team that you really can think of that can give, you know, well, not I shouldn't say give, but they're the only team that was remaining in the playoffs when they were playing the Suns that were the most dangerous, that can give any team a run, give any team trouble, you know, because they had matchup nightmares for everybody. Because when you look at the Clippers, they were a team that was built on, you know, having two superstars, or should I say, you know, some people might look at Paul George not as a superstar, but a really, really good all-star. And Paul George, and one superstar in Kawhi Leonard, who was a focal point to help bring LA a championship just to a different organization. So when you look at that, that's what the media doesn't want. The media doesn't want the Clippers to succeed. As much as they sit there and try to say, oh, they respect the Clippers, you know, because of what they did being down 0-2 in every series and all those things like that, that doesn't matter. That doesn't matter at all, because if you really respected them, you would have gave them respect they deserve from the beginning of this season going into it. I understand what happened in the bubble. I understand all that. But that was a flawed championship. That was one of those championships where it was weird. It was a weird situation. You know, a lot of players didn't want to be there. A lot of players sucked it up and, you know, went because of just for the fact of, you know, money involved, of course, and just the fact that the NBA really pushed for that, you know, to have some type of sports for, you know, the fans to watch on TV and things like that. So that's what made a lot of NBA players just go ahead and go through with it, even though they didn't feel comfortable. Now, I will say the Lakers, they did win the championship. You have to give them credit there. But at the same time, that was just pretty much LeBron motivating a team to let's do this because, hey, this might be my last run at a championship, and let's do it for Kobe Bryant, who had passed at the time. So, I mean, you know, you could look at that championship and say what you want, but like I said, that was just different. I mean, the Lakers did win it, so you have to give them credit, but it's always going to be looked at as a Laker town, LA, and the breakthrough is going to have to happen at some point. I just hope that it happens, you know, with Kawhi Leonard and the Clippers keeping the same roster, staying together so they can make another run at it. Because really, when you look at it, they're the threat to the Lakers. They're the threat to any other team out here in Cali. They're a threat to any other team outside of Cali, because really they're a matchup nightmare for pretty much any team they face. You can't stop Kawhi Leonard. When Paul George is going, you got a problem. If Reggie Jackson is going, you really got a problem. They're unbeatable. And if Marcus Morris is actually chips in and plays the way he's supposed to, well, they're a championship team. It's just the way it is. No other team could beat them in a 7-game series. No other team has the depth that they have. No other team has the fortitude that they have as a team, and even the coaching staff. You know, now when you look at Ty Lue, you know, the way he coached and the way he did a lot of things, way he implemented a lot of things, you know, to them, and how they played being down 0-2 in a lot of those series was encouraging basketball. It was basketball beyond like the court. It was mental more than it was anything else. And the way he had them gelling and thinking and believing in each other when they were down those 0-2 situations in every series they were in these playoffs before they exited, it was amazing to see. And, you know, the media will sit there. I've heard, you know, Shannon Sharp and a couple other ones, you know, they would say, oh, well, I didn't think the Clippers, I have to give them respect. You know, they didn't want to say it. They didn't want to, you know, initiate anything like that. But, you know, they had to give respect where respect is due. But I know they're all happy that the Clippers are out because it gives them an opportunity to say, hey, well, the Clippers couldn't even do it while the Lakers were down. And that's something that they'll probably try to use against the Clippers going forward, you know. But at the same time, like I said, this, and that's more of the reason why the Clippers should run it back and keep the same team, because they got an opportunity to go really far. And I hate the fact that Chauncey Billups actually left the Clippers, but I know he's got a head coaching job in Portland. So, I mean, that definitely bodes well for, you know, him. And I, you know, appreciate everything he done for the organization and everything. I'm pretty sure they do, too. But, you know, it would have been nice to have Chauncey Billups back as well. But hopefully they can keep the rest of the band together and make another run so they can make the media unhappy when they win the championship. Because I think if Kawhi Leonard comes back for another 2 years, say he does that hypothetically, I think another 2 years, they'll be in a finals. You know, whether they win it or not, we'll see. But I personally think they can win it. But I'm just saying, we'll see if they do or don't. But I think another 2 years with Kawhi Leonard, you're going to an NBA finals, because I just don't see really any other team that can threaten them as of right now, as teams are constructed as we speak. But I mean, you know, a lot can happen between now and then, trades, offseason trades. You know how that goes. But we'll see exactly how that pans out for them. But I really, really like what I've been seeing, you know, the Clippers through this past season, and especially through the playoffs. They were amazing team, and if they would have had Kawhi, I definitely think they'd be in the finals right now. But hey, that's my take on the whole situation, and let me know what you think about it in the comment section. You know, I find the media to be very, very you know, easygoing right now. It's no haywire or anything like that because the Clippers are not in there. But I definitely despise the fact the Clippers are not in there, because I said before, the wrong team is in the finals in the Western Conference. And that's just the way it is. But like I said, leave any comments in the comment section. Let me know what you think about it, and we can go ahead and talk and engage as always. Cali out.